cool. So I want to bring up, where is she? There she is. Sarah, come on up. Can you welcome Sarah up to the stage? So I'm really excited about this. She's one of my favorites. They're all my favorite. She is just a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful person. She's from Canada, which we all love Canada, apparently. Every Canadian has got a great response from you guys. This makes me jealous. I'm like, whatever, Canada. She's great. She has such a great heart. She has such an amazing tenderness and sweetness about her. I'm really excited for you guys to hear her preach. And welcome one more time, Sarah. So, ready? Yeah.
You want to sing for your stuff? You want to sing for your stuff?
No, I'm gonna sit. Yeah. Woo! Guys, I feel closer if I sit right here, awkwardly. All right. Yeah, guys, apparently our countries are, like, best friends, and I didn't know this, but it's awesome. You guys are so beautiful. Yeah. I loved watching you guys worship tonight. There was something so, so sweet about your worship. And I really felt the Lord was saying, these are my devoted ones. Your hearts are so, so devoted to Him. He's just so good. Yeah. It's such an honor to be here, to be in this country, and I've had such an amazing time so far. You guys have welcomed me so greatly with your beautiful scenery and your amazing food, and I know I'm going to be going home with a couple extra pounds in my suitcase and maybe on my body a little bit from all the amazing food, but hey, that is all right. But yeah. I just really felt, when I asked the Lord, we were in Dublin in the beginning of this week, and I really felt that I was going to be speaking here in Belfast, and so I was just like, Lord, what do you want to say to them? What do you want to say? And I just heard Him say, bring the sunshine. So I was like, yeah. I was like, all right, I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm excited about that. And whether that is joy, because I can just feel His presence so thick right now. I just burst into laughing or tears or whatever that looks like. But hey. Anyways, so yeah, I heard Him say, bring the sunshine. And, I kept seeing, our whole team just kept seeing rainbows popping up everywhere. And that's really, I don't know if that's something common here, but it is not common where we're from. It's rare that we see a rainbow where we're from. And I just felt like it was so significant for this time. And yeah. All the rainbows just kept popping up, and so I felt like the Lord was saying, this land is a land of promise. Yeah. Ireland is a land of promise. And I felt like during worship tonight, I actually was getting, like, kind of stomach pain. And I knew, I'm like, okay, this is not normal. And so I felt like I was saying, like, this land is pregnant with promise. And I could feel it as you guys were worshiping tonight. You guys are so ready. You're so ready. And it's like there's been this passion, and there's just been this stirring in your hearts And I love, I could feel the anticipation in the air when we first walked into this place. And I was like hit with this excitement. And it's so encouraging. And it's every person here that I've met has been so hungry. And it's actually really inspired me to go back to that place of hunger again. Because it's so easy to get comfortable where we are. When things become the normal. And for me, I'm going to put this away because I don't think I'm going there. for me, being immersed in the culture of Bethel for about 2 years now, I've noticed that there's been a difference in how I've approached being in school in second year. I'm a student in second year and at the school of ministry. And it's like it's changed between the hunger that I came with going into first year, where I had never experienced the presence of God so tangibly before in my life, to where it's like become the normal of, oh yeah, like that's what happens in worship. Or maybe I won't go to all of the services because I know what's supposed to happen. I've experienced that. And I've been being in this place has stirred so much hunger in my heart again, and I feel like I'm back in the beginning where I first encountered the presence of God. And there's been a few moments on this trip where all we've had to do is just start talking about Jesus. Like, no real topic or, like, message. It's just, like, just Jesus and who he is and what he's done in our lives and how he's been so faithful. And every time I talk about his faithfulness, I'm just moved to tears. Because even right now, I'm sitting here in front of all of you, and I can't even believe it. It's such an honor. And it's brought me back to the first moment where I first encountered him. It's kind of like, if you've ever been in love, that feeling of that first love that you've had, where it's like all you can think about. You go to sleep thinking about that person. You wake up thinking about them. And when you're away from them, it's where you want to be. You just want to be with them. And one thing that I really noticed on this trip has been absolutely amazing, but it's been go, and it's been incredible, but I've felt this thing in my heart where I feel like, God, I miss you, and it's taken me to this place of, okay, putting everything else aside, putting all of the fun aside, putting all of the ministry, so to speak, we always need to come back to that place of just being us and him. Even on Sunday when we were in Dublin area, Jen, who was leading worship, the beautiful blonde leading worship tonight, she talked about just the face of God, looking face to face, seeking his face. And if anything else becomes our priority other than his face, looking at him face to face, being with him, then there's nothing else. There's no point to anything else. It's not about the music. It's not about the worship. It's not about the great message. It's about him. It's about him. I strongly feel that this is a land of promise, and your hearts are so ready for this promise to be birthed and to come forth, and it's coming up from the ground. Like, I feel this hope just rising up. I had this picture, did a painting a few nights ago, and it was of a tree, and the roots were going down so deep, and the blossoms were coming up actually from the roots, and they didn't even come from normally from the top of the tree. It's like they were blossoming from the roots, and I feel that this is a word for this place and for you here in Belfast, that you are blooming so deeply from the roots, and there's so much life coming up, and there's this spring. It's like spring is here. Spring is here. Yeah, the sun shines here. You're so ready. And just as Audrey was speaking on our identity and who we are as sons and daughters, the more that we come into that place of recognizing who we are as a son and daughter of God, the more the promises of God will be released in the land that you're in. Christ in you, the hope of glory. There's actually, how am I doing in time? Good? Okay, time, good. Okay, cool. So, I found this quote this afternoon, and it's from William Barclay, and he said, "Jesus is the yes to every promise of God." Jesus is the yes to every promise of God. Jesus is the yes to every promise of God. Come on. So the wonderful thing is that every promise, every dream that you have in your heart, when Jesus died, he actually fulfilled that on the cross. So it's just us walking out the process of walking in that promise that he's already paid for. He's already paid for it. So every promise that you have in your life, that you're waiting to see fulfilled, he's already paid for it. And I strongly felt tonight that to pray for two groups of people, and for the first group of those of you that feel like you have received promises from the Lord but haven't seen the fulfillment of it yet. Yeah, can I have those of you stand if you feel like you've received promises from God and you're waiting for them to be fulfilled? Could you stand? I need to stand on this one. Ooh. Yeah, and those of you that are still sitting, could you stretch out your hands to these people? Jesus, I thank you for what you did. I thank you for what you did on the cross, and you paid for every single life. You paid for every single life. And every promise and every dream that is in our hearts, you paid for it. It's actually ours. Because you paid for it. And we didn't even deserve it, but you paid for it. So God, I pray for every single person here who has received a promise from you, who has received a word from you, and is still waiting for that fulfillment. God, I pray for grace to be imparted to walk through the process, to embrace the process. Thank you, God, that you created process for relationship. You created process for relationship because you wanted to walk with us. You wanted to be with us. You wanted to journey with us through this whole thing called life. God, just I pray for grace to be able to walk through this process with you and to know that it has already been paid for. It is ours, and we are just waiting for the fulfillment. And your timing is so perfect. Your timing is so perfect. God, help us. Help us to trust your ability. Your ability to take us where we need to go, when we need to be there, to know exactly where we're supposed to be, to trust you, God. Help us to trust you, God. Amen. You guys can sit down. And also, if you could stand, if you actually feel like you haven't received a promise and you want one, if you haven't received a dream from God and you want vision for your life and you want to dream with the Lord, I want you to stand. You scared me for a little bit there. I was like, whoa. Yeah. Jesus, you're the greatest dreamer of all. God, I pray for every single heart, for the eyes of our heart to be opened. The eyes of our hearts to be opened. We get to see you with unveiled face. God, I pray that the veil is taken off of our eyes so that we see what you see. We see what you see, God. Yeah, I just keep hearing him say, dream bigger, dream bigger. You're not dreaming bigger enough. You are created for greatness. You are created for greatness. Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, that you have the best for us. Thank you, God, that even what we think is the best for our lives, you always give us even better. We actually can't lose. We can never lose because he won. We actually live in the victory of Jesus. So we get to have the best life ever because he paid for it. Jesus, thank you, God. thank you, God, for these dreamers. But I pray for dreams in the day and dreams in the night. That you'd wake up dreaming, that you'd go to sleep dreaming. Live our ordinary lives. Oh. No more ordinary lives, because you were made to be extraordinary. You were made to be extraordinary. Oh. Oh, thank you, God. Yeah, I am. You guys can sit down. I actually feel like I'm supposed to sing. I hope that's okay. I know you've done a lot of singing, but I just kept hearing this song go through my head about the love of God, because what else is better than the love of God? And you guys will know it, so you can sing with me. I can smell your love forever. I could sing of 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 your love forever. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for your love. Thank you, God, that it was because of the love that you died. Thank you, God, that it was because of your love that we can live the greatest life ever. Jesus, help us to see ourselves and see our lives with your eyes, because it's so much greater.
Amen. I think she deserves a better clap than that. There it is. That was awesome. I loved it. Thanks for singing, by the way. That was really cool. Yeah, Ireland. Winter's over. The springtime has come. Ha ha. That's a good word.